Hello everyone, welcome to Master to Teach Step by Step Guide. In this video, you will learn how to create RDS instance in AWS, Relational Database Service. How to connect the RDS database from the EC2 server, which we have created in the previous video. For the security and better performance, we are keeping the application layer and the database layer separately. I will try my best to explain step by step. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please click on the subscribe button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Amazon RDS is a web service that makes it easier to set up, operate, and scale a relational database in the AWS cloud. It provides cost efficient, resizable capacity for an industry standard relational database and manage common database administration tasks. Open the AWS console page. Search for the RDS and click and open it. You can see the promotion of Amazon Aurora, which is MySQL and PostgreSQL compatible enterprise class database, starting at less than $1 per day. Aurora supports up to 64 TB of auto-scaling storage capacity, 6-way replication across 3 availability zones, and 15 low-latency read replicas. We are not going to this for this time. We will cover in upcoming tutorials. For the list of databases that are already created, navigate to the database menu. As you can see, there are 0 for now. Click in Create Database. Here you can see options for the RDS. Let's go through one by one. First step, choose a database creation methods. Standard Create and Easy Create. In standard, we have to set all of the configuration options, including one of availability, security, backup, and maintenance, whereas in EasyCreate, AWS recommended best practice configuration. For now, let's go with the standard so that we can explore all options one by one. The next option is engine options. You can see there are 6 different types of relational database services that you can use in AWS: Amazon Aurora, MySQL, MariaDB, PostgreSQL, Oracle, and MySQL SQL Server. AWS has non-relational database option as well, which is DynamoDB, which we will learn about it in upcoming tutorials. For now, we are going to set up MySQL. MySQL is the most popular open source database in the world. MySQL offers the rich feature of MySQL community scales with the flexibility to easily scale compute resources or storage capacity for your database. It supports database size up to 64 TB, supports general purpose memory optimized and burstable performance instance classes, supports automated backup and point in time recovery, supports up to 5 read replicas per instance within a single region or cross region. Let's move further. Now, select the editions or version of MySQL that you need as per your programming language. For now, let's choose 5.7.2 and 2. Next is the templates option. Production is used for high availability and fast, consistent performance. Dev or test is used for development use outside of a production environment, which will be cheaper than production. So let's choose dev or test template for now. Settings. Specify the DB instance identifier name that is unique for all DB instances, which will help to identify the database. Note that it's not the database name. Master to teach RDS DB. The next step is set up the master user of the database. Admin as master username and password as a password for now. It's not a good and secure password, but for now, let's use it. Another option is DB instance size. There is more option to choose as per your requirement, as we choose 1 core CPU with 1 GB RAM while we set up the Ubuntu server in EC2. For now, let's go with the minimum option, which is 2 CPUs with 8 GB RAM, EBS 450 Mbps, general purpose SSD. Size for now, 8 GB is sufficient. Another wow feature is auto-scaling. Either you can enable auto-scaling your DB or not. you can set up minimum up to 21 GB and maximum up to 65,536 GB. Next option is availability and durability. If you need a backup in case of server down, then create a standby instance that will create a standby in a different availability zone to provide data redundancy, eliminates I/O freezes, and minimize latency spikes during system backup. Next is VPC. For now, we are going to set up in default VPC, which we choose the same in EC2. We are setting up EC2 and RDS instances in the same network so that we have another option publicly accessible. If we choose no here, RDS will not assign a public IP address to the database. Only Amazon EC2 instances and devices inside the VPC can connect to your database. That means we cannot even connect this database from your local terminal. To connect to this database, we have to go through the EC2 instance which is in the same network, mean VPC. Choose the VPC security groups. For now, let's choose the existing VPC security group which we had created while configuring EC2 in the previous video, which is EC2 Linux tutorial. Choose availability zone. Currently, we are working in North Virginia, where are 6 availability zones. For now, let's go with no preference. Another is database port. 3306 is the default DB port. Let's move with the default port. Another option is database authentication, where we can set up another extra layer of security beside database username and password, that is the IAM role. There is another additional configuration as well. Let's remove automatic backup for now. Another option, let's leave it as it is for now. Estimated monthly cost, DB instance $127.75, storage $0.92. Total monthly bill is about $128.67. After finish all settings, click in create database. It will take some time to create the database as per our configuration. During this, let's see one another part which is inbound rules in EC2. In EC2, click in security groups and click the security groups that we have created while configuring EC2. As you can see, we have open access to only HTTP with port number 80 and SSH with port number 22. The RDS that we are creating can access through port number 3306, so that we have to open for it as well. So, edit inbound rules, add rules. You can see there are lots of options. Choose MySQL/Aurora. Using TCP request in port number 3306 from, you can set to anywhere or can specify to allow the request from the particular EC2 instances application as well. For now, let's make it anywhere and save rules. Let's check our RDS instance. Now it's running and active. Up to now, we have done two jobs. One, we set up the Ubuntu server in the previous video using EC2 instance for PHP. And second, we set up the RDS instance for the MySQL database. Now let's move to access the MySQL database from EC2 instance. Open the terminal and connect to the server as we learned before in the previous video. Now, if we try MySQL, it says the program MySQL can be found in the following package. So, let's install the MySQL client package first. Sudo apt-get install MySQL client core 5.7. Do you want to continue? Yes. Now, we can use the MySQL command. Let's connect to MySQL DB. As you know, to connect a database, we need three things: host, username, and password. We have a master username and password. What about the host? For host info, open the database list. Select and click for detail of the database. Here, endpoint represents the host. Now, let's connect to the database. The command to connect the database is MySQL /h, which is for the hostname. Copy and paste the endpoint. -P, which is for the port 3306, -u for the username admin, and -p for the password. Do not place the password here. Enter without password. It will ask the password. We place the password as password. Now we can access the database. Now you can create the database tables in the RDS instance. In this way, you can create an RDS instance for the separate database environment and set up as per your needs in AWS. In the next video tutorial, you will learn how to set up a simple PHP code application using these EC2 and RDS instances. I hope you learned from this video tutorial. If you have any questions or comments, please make sure to leave a comment in the comment section below. Also, please be sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you very much for watching. Check us out for more in IT tutorial and guide on website mastertoteach.com. And we will see you again soon. Bye.